What up? It's the trooper. Bazinga. I don't know what bazinga means, but it says it. Thursday, Trooper Thursday, back at the Westgate. Got here in time to get a little coffee action going before the game starts. Just played the silly little locals slot tournament and ended up with nothing. Can't really complain though, I've done well overall on that thing. Can't win every time, or can you? That's who you're talking about?
No, that's the one guy I follow that he sells all kinds of shit.
I've heard that name before, I think.
He bought like $10,000 worth of those outdoor heaters.
Yeah.
He made like $30,000 on it.
You know, there's a bunch of people who buy like crates of shit from Amazon. Here we are again on Trooper Thursday. Got a nice little game going in there. Nice little mixture of local, regular players in the game and people from out of town, as far away as New York, Baltimore, I don't know where else, other places. And time to get up and take a little pee-pee break. That's right, I said it, pee-pee break. And you don't drink coffee like I drink it and not have to visit a urinal at least once in a while. Got some real nice weather action going out here. I hate to say that because it's supposed to be winter and it's 63 degrees at 5:47 in the PM. If we don't have more of a winter, I'm gonna feel somewhat neglected by Mother Nature. I sure will be glad when this COVID situation is over. By the way, I don't know why I never spoke about this in the vlog. I don't know why, but I guess it was just like a really sensitive subject at the time, but I am 99.9% sure that I had the COVID-19. Christina and I both, it was months ago, around the time of the lockdown. Christina started feeling, she woke up one day under the weather, just feeling bad, feeling sick, like, oh, I'm sick, like that kind of sick, you know what I mean? Pretty sure she had a little bit of a fever, because I remember I made her pancakes with fruit, and it didn't make her feel better. But about 2 days later, I started feeling sick as well. For me, I felt like I had the flu, but only about one third as bad. As far as like the aches and the fever and the sniffles or whatever, it just felt like a really tame version of the flu. But about, I would say probably on the third or fourth day of Christina's feeling sick, probably on the second day of my feeling sick, she complained that she couldn't taste anything. So this was so early on in this COVID situation that I said to her, come on, that's in your head. You're just paranoid. Because when she got sick, she was already getting scared because of all the stuff in the media about how deadly this virus is. But she swore she couldn't taste anything or smell anything, and I could taste fine. But about 2 days or so after she complained of not being able to taste anything, I couldn't taste jack. Like hot sauce, salt, like nothing really had a taste anymore. It was as if my tongue was numb, but there was no numbness. Does that make any sense? I tell you that I'm 99.9% sure that I had it because I've never had a test. Never been to the doctor for it. Anything of that nature. I'm not gonna go get a test because who cares if I had it? I'm pretty sure I had it. What else is going around where you legit can't taste? It was so severe, the loss of taste, that I legitimately thought that it was nothing like I'd ever experienced before. I've never had a situation where I couldn't taste anything. So overall, feeling sick lasted for like, I would say max 2 weeks, but it wasn't that rough. It was only rough for like maybe 4 or 5 days. But the non-tasting thing was a good 2 to 3 weeks of not being able to taste anything. And now, everything is back to normal. I can taste Pizza Rock as if I was 7 years old, having it for the first time. Oh wait, I didn't have Pizza Rock when I was 7, but you know what I'm trying to say. I guess the real question is, Trooper, how come you never told us this before? How come you never said you had coronavirus? They're coming to get me. That's a damn good question. I don't know why I never said it before. While we were sick, we really weren't making videos. There were large spans of time this year where I didn't make any videos. So, I don't know. What else was there to tell you? I mean, I thought about telling the vlog several times and then I just forget about it. But what do you guys think? What do you think about the fact that I had the Rona? Pretty sure I had the Rona. And like I said, it felt like the flu divided by 3. I would put it about, I mean, is there a friggin' war happening above here or what? It's like one chopper after another. I don't know. I don't know what else is there to tell you. I wonder what questions you might have about it. I mean, no, we never went to the doctor. We never got tested or anything like that. And I'm not gonna go get tested now. Here's the sick thing. And I know this isn't true for some people. For a very tiny percentage of the people who catch this SARS, coronavirus 2, whatever it's called, a very small percentage of the people who catch it, for those people, it isn't like this. But for me, the least worst effect that coronavirus has had on me personally was actually catching the virus and being sick. Of all the things that coronavirus has done to me personally, and my vlog and my game and my whole way of making a living, including the loss of Go Gamble Blend and temporary loss of Go Gamble Blend, and just basically the falling off of everything, the least of the bad things that happened to me was actually catching it and getting sick. And I know what you're thinking, Trooper, what happened to you? How has this affected you? Well, you know, I don't like to whine about stuff like that because I know that there are people that have it worse than me. I mean, there are people that have had a business for 30 years that had to shut down because they were locked down and not allowed to do business anymore. I feel really bad for those people. My thing has been greatly affected. We'll get into it. Maybe we'll get into it in some future videos about how the pandemic has affected me, adversely affected me. But I'll tell you, the main one that really comes to mind that might be, it's definitely worse than actually getting sick, because the getting sick part, for me, getting it wasn't that bad. Something that was way worse than that is the depression that I feel on a day-to-day basis. You know, coming to the Strip, you know, day-to-day, and going downtown day-to-day, and even coming over here to the Westgate on Thursdays, and having this not be the Vegas that I've always known, and having this be so drastically different and so regulated and so locked down. I just saw on Twitter that gaming, you know, sort of like reiterated the COVID regulations to casinos prior to Super Bowl weekend, basically saying that they're gonna be out here fining the shit out of casinos and other businesses because casinos can't control every person, you know? And when a guy walks through there and his mask is hanging down around his chin and there's no one around at the moment to tell him, but a regulator sees it, bam, they're gonna fine him. You know what I mean? Which is unfair. I know what you're thinking, these casinos can afford it, but I'm not so sure they can. Anyway, I wear my mask because of that. And what else is there to tell you? Wow, this went to a dreary note. Let's head back to the game.
Ah.
I was going to give you a third cover.
Oh.
But I know you need it.
I do. Who's it on, Jay? Is it me?
Yes, Jim, it's on you, sir.
Well, I can't see the shit through the shit.
We're just
give this guy aces.
Aces, right here. Right here, I'm in trouble. And I'm not looking. I'm not looking for the top bottom. There it is, right there. Bang. Bang, right there. That was close.
Oh, shit. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. 30.
Yeah, I was gonna do that a few days.
I just said that. Are you listening?
I mean, I'm taking a video right now. Drew.
Listen, there's no shame in folding. You can make it 25 the next hand. Whatever you want to do.
Dude, I really don't care.
There's a new hand in 5 seconds.
What's the total? I don't need that.
Let's talk. 166.
You know, I owe you a whole bunch of coffees.
Don't do it. All right. I need 2 4s.
How's that?
For a high hand. Got him.
You got him. You got me.
No slow rolls.
No slow rolls.
Just forget what you had. Don't even look at it. Muck it. I'm just kidding. Oh, it was a fair hand. It was fair.
The 2 times you wanted to catch me today, I'm not at my best.
Oh, okay.
It was high for you. Come on now.
I started vlog.
That should be like drunk guy from East Coast calls you a six
you're,
high.
You're gonna.
Right, I got it.
You're gonna start a vlog from the floor?
Yeah.
Right here. I got it.
Oh, Lord. Oh, I got it on video. Don't worry.
No.
It's on video.
I was trying to get your chips.
No,
I
fucking spilled my chips. Those are not my chips. Those are Jay's chips. Well, there you have it, my friends, fellow troops. Oh, the moon. How's it going, moon? Moon action. The end of another Trooper Thursday. How many have we had now? What number Trooper Thursday is this? Count the one that was on a Tuesday. Count it. It counts, even though it was on a Tuesday. Yo, what a fun game. Shout out to everybody, Todd, Carlos, Pat, Ryan. Oh my goodness, I didn't get seat six's name. Shit. Nice Go Gamble hat, though. Shout out to everybody who made it to the game, and Max, and everybody. We had a lot of fun. As usual, it is always more fun when I win, and I did win $300 even. And, yeah. What else is there to tell you? I mean, actually, there's a lot to tell you. You know, I've been thinking about how the coronavirus has affected me, and it's got me stressed, not gonna lie. It's got me stressed, it's got me depressed. Both of those things, they both end with est. What? Yo, I am going to head back to Casa del Troopers. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time.